India marked a major milestone in its strategic capabilities with the first test of the K-4 submarine-launched ballistic missile (SLBM) from an operational SSBN on November 27th. Viewers may note that prior to this, the missile had undergone at least two tests, both conducted using an underwater pontoon. The nuclear-capable missile, boasting a range of 3,500 kilometers or around 2,175 miles, was launched from INS Arighaat ballistic missile submarine, which entered service earlier this year. This advancement significantly enhances India's nuclear triad, bolstering its second strike capability to deter adversaries while overcoming operational challenges. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes why K-4 SLBM is a game-changer for India. Before we proceed, a word on NordVPN, which is one of the most trusted VPN brands worldwide that has a no-log policy validated by Deloitte, an industry-leading Big Four auditing firm. NordVPN provides an encrypted tunnel that protects your privacy by preventing external entry to your internet traffic, as well as enabling you to access content that's blocked based on geolocation. Best of all, with one NordVPN account, you can secure up to 6 devices at the same time. Get an exclusive NordVPN deal with massive savings by going to nordvpn.com/defense or clicking the link in the description. It's risk-free with Nord's 30-day money-back guarantee. Named after Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam, K-4 or Kalam-4, is a nuclear-capable, intermediate-range, submarine-launched ballistic missile developed by the Defense Research and Development Organization (DRDO) of India to arm its Arighaat-class submarines. The K-4 is a submarine-launched ballistic missile that's composed of two stages. The missile is reported to be 12 meters or 39 feet long, with a diameter of 1.3 meters or 4 foot 3 inches, and weighs nearly 17 tons. It can carry a warhead weighing up to 2 tons and is powered by solid rocket propellant. The K-4 uses a powerful nose-mounted motor, which has two diametrically opposite mounted nozzles that fires underwater and enable the transition of the missile through water, break the surface, and continue the ascent into the atmosphere for the first few seconds. The gases ejected from this system create a gas bubble encapsulating around the missile, which reduces the drag during underwater transition. The four control surfaces at the base of the missile provide the necessary aerodynamic control to the missile. As a countermeasure against ballistic missile defense systems, the K-4 can perform three-dimensional maneuvers. The DRDO stated that the missile aimed to achieve high accuracy. The missile uses an inertial navigation system with GPS, or NAVIC, for guidance. The accuracy is high, with alleged circular error probable of less than 10 meters, or 33 feet. India is one of only a handful of countries that has an operational nuclear triad, the ability to launch nukes from land, sea, and air. India's nuclear triad includes land-based ICBMs like Agni series missiles deployed from silos and mobile launchers, aircraft carrying free-fall nuclear bombs like Dassault Rafale and Arighaat ballistic missile submarines, which are armed with K-series SLBM. Ballistic missile submarines armed with SLBMs are the most survivable leg of the nuclear triad. While a first strike might wipe out a country's land-based missiles and nuclear bombers, it's very difficult to track a ballistic missile submarine patrolling quietly in the depths of the ocean, and it's almost impossible to take them all out in a first strike. INS Arighaat SSBN, from which K-4 SLBM was launched, has the pennant number S3 and is the second of its kind for India after the INS Arighaat. Arighaat means destroyer of the enemy in Hindi. The submarine displaces around 6,000 tons. It has a length of 365 feet or 111 meters. It's powered by a single CLWR B1 compact light water reactor that produces 83 megawatts and drives a single 7-blade propeller. So INS Arighaat has unlimited range and endurance, limited only by essential supplies. INS Arighaat has a maximum speed of 17.5 miles per hour, or 28 kilometers per hour when surfaced, and 27 miles per hour, or 44 kilometers per hour when submerged. It's thought to be able to operate at depths of 1,300 feet, or 350 meters. INS Arighaat has 4 VLS, vertical launch system cells, that can accommodate 12 K-15 or 4 K-4 missiles. For India, maintaining a credible nuclear triad is crucial for ensuring strategic stability and deterring aggression from nuclear-armed neighbors like China and Pakistan. Until now, India's SSBN fleet relied on the K-15 SLBM, which has a limited range of 750 kilometers, or approximately 465 miles. This restricted India's ability to target critical sites in Pakistan and China without exposing its submarines to significant risks. To compensate for the K-15's short range, Indian SSBNs would have to operate in nearby waters such as the Arabian Sea or the South China Sea, increasing their vulnerability to detection and counter-strikes by adversary forces. The successful test of the K-4 missile marks a game-changing shift in India's strategic posture. With a range of up to 3,500 kilometers, SSBNs armed with K-4 missiles can strike high-value targets across most of China, including Beijing, and any location in Pakistan, all while operating securely from bastions in the northern Bay of Bengal. This extended range significantly reduces exposure to anti-submarine warfare (ASW) operations, enhancing the survivability of India's SSBN fleet, a crucial element in maintaining credible deterrence under the country's no-first-use doctrine. It strengthens the MAD, Mutual Assured Destruction, paradigm when it comes to attacking India with nukes. According to the concept of MAD, if the other side knew that initiating a nuclear strike would also inevitably lead to their own destruction, they would not initiate a nuclear attack. So the K-4 strengthens the sea leg, ensuring the efficacy of India's nuclear posture. But K-4 is not the end. India is actively working on extending its SLBM capabilities. K-5 with 5,000 kilometer range and MIRV-enabled K-6 with 6,000 kilometer range is under development.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.